As y'all can see, I'm hyped than a motherfucker. You tell something different? Y'all know why I'm here. It's the main fucking event. Bitch, I got my motherfucking braces off. I'm naked tooth out here, bitch. Can y'all believe it's literally been pretty much 2.5 years since I had braces? I don't have braces no more. It's like, what the fuck? Like, it's a little weird. A bitch can feel her gums now. This is a weird feeling. Like, I ain't been able to feel my gums or my lips in about 2.5 years. Like, this is a big fucking deal. All right, y'all. So, hella people was just on my Instagram. I posted some pictures of my teeth and my retainer and all the shit. And I put up some little quote cards that was pretty much saying that, you know, I wouldn't believe what the fuck I just literally been through getting my braces off yesterday. That shit was crazy. So what I want to do is share with you guys my experience on getting my braces off. So as you all know, the office that I go to is Western Dental. We haven't had the best of the relationship, you know, as you know, a patient in a dental office could possibly have. Unfortunately, getting my braces off, like ending this journey, it wasn't any better than when I started it, which is very fucking unfortunate. Yesterday, I had an appointment at 9 o'clock to get my braces off. I was very fucking excited. I'm super juiced. I'm like, all right, I'm about to get my braces off. This is awesome. I'm gonna get a retainer. And then, you know, I'm gonna start this post-brace experience. Cool, juiced. So I go in there, the orthodontist come and look at my teeth and she's like, you know, do you feel ready or whatever? I'm like, absolutely, get these bitches off my teeth. I am excited, I'm fucking juiced. So they have one of the dental assistants or whatever the fuck you call them, come over and start to cut my braces off. Not gonna lie, I was a little bit nervous because I've been in an office before when other people were getting their braces off. And they were saying that it was pretty painful. So I was kind of, you know, expecting it to be painful because of the way that other people were reacting around me as I went through my journey with braces. So I'm expecting this shit to hurt, but it turns out that the shit don't really hurt that bad. I feel like some teeth, like in the front, that were always like sensitive during my journey will always be the ones that would hurt. Those kind of hurt a little bit when they cut them off. But I mean, it was a clean and quick process. I mean, the lady that was cutting my braces off was actually like, you're doing such a good job. And I'm like, just get these bitches off. Like, I don't care. I just don't want them on. Like, I have hella tattoos, so I know how to deal with pain. And you know, sitting in a chair for 2 hours getting a tattoo is very different from sitting in a chair for 5 minutes getting your braces cut off. And it probably wasn't even 5 minutes. It probably was less than that. So getting them cut off, not that bad. So if any of you guys are nervous about that in the upcoming future, don't be scared because it's not going to be that bad. Sorry, I just got a text message. It's not going to be that bad. And it shouldn't take that long. So even if it does hurt, it's good. Just suck it up for a few fucking minutes. Not that big of a deal. I got my braces cut off and of course there's a whole bunch of glue residue still, or like the cement from them attaching the brackets to your tooth still on your teeth. So the orthodontist had to come back over and shave it all off. So cool, they cut it off. She let me rinse out my mouth. And then the orthodontist comes over to shave all of the glue off of my mouth, which probably was the longest process. So at this point of my visit, I am very excited because things are going smoothly and they never fucking do at Western Dental. So I'm shocked, I'm excited, I'm ready to go back to work. I'm like, yeah, we moving great. You know, I'm looking in the mirror like, oh shit, my teeth is naked. You know what? You know, when you get that vibe that, you know, things are too good to be true, or, you know, you get that vibe that other people vibe around you isn't as good as you would like it to be, like something is about to happen, like you just feel that energy from other people around you that something is about to go wrong. That's how I felt. I was sitting in a chair, and I was sitting in a chair for quite some time, probably like 5 minutes. I'm like, why am I still fucking sitting here? Like, you already shaved everything off. Like, it's just a matter of you explaining to me how to wear my retainer, just give me the care instructions and just tell me what I need to do moving forward. And, you know, tell me what the post-brace journey is for me. Like, To be honest, I didn't know or really think about the fact that after I got my braces off and I got my retainer, that I still would have to come to the dental office to, I would still have to come to the dental office for like routine checkups on my retainers and make sure that my teeth is still fine. Which I'm kind of pissed off about, because had I known that this relationship was going to be as long as it fucking is, I would have never started at Western Dental, because I've been over them. So here's a tip. Make damn sure you're okay with the office that you're going to for your braces, because you're going to be stuck with them like a bad relationship if it doesn't go well. Go fucking figured. So I'm still in this bad relationship. I'm sitting there and the nurse comes over and she gives me the, here's your retainer. At this point, I'm juiced because of the fact that my wires are gold and I hella asked for this a lot. So I was juiced when they then show me my retainers, which have gold wires, which is fucking awesome. And you know, I'm feeling great. I'm feeling great, even though I feel like the energy still isn't great around me. So then the dental assistant asked me, she's like, hey, did the doctor come over and show you how to put your retainers in? I was like, no, she didn't show me. And then, so she comes back over and she's like, yeah, so let's just put them on and make sure that they fit. I'm like, make sure that they fit. I'm like, bitch, here we go. Here we go. Here we go with that fucking bullshit. Make sure that they fit. Bitch, why won't they just fit? Like, it's almost like she knew that they wasn't gonna fit. How do you already got negative energy towards my fucking retainers fitting or not? That, strike one. So she puts the fucking top ones in. She pushes it in a little bit. She's like, yeah, no. She calls the fucking assistant over. It's like, yeah, these don't fit. I'm like, bitch, you just put it in my mouth. Bruh. You just put it in my fucking mouth. And you instantly know that they don't fit. It's almost like you been looked at them when they came in and you was like, these ain't gonna fit. As soon as she says that, my whole energy changed. And then she puts the bottom one on and she's like, yeah, no, the bottom ones don't even fit at all. So I am livid, livid. I promise you, I'm still mad right now. So I'm sitting there, I'm like, what the fuck? And then she's like, yeah, no, we're gonna have to order new ones. And I'm like, order new ones? Like, y'all always fucking up. Y'all always fucking up. And then she stops and she puts them down. She's like, yeah, so see what the problem is. The place where we ordered them from with the gold wires had the tendency of not fitting. And I'm like, bitch, why would the fuck you not tell me that in the first place when I asked you, can I get the ones with the gold wire in the first place? You should have did some type of disclosure like, look, when we order from the, we can order them with gold wires, but the place that we order with gold wires, for some reason, they don't make them that great and they always end up not fitting. It's a high percent chance that they won't fit. I would have made the executive decision to get fucking silver, even though I didn't fucking want silver, just so we didn't have this fucking issue. So then she was like, well, we can order it from there again, but it's a possibility that they won't fit again. And I'm like, well, bitch, that's out of the question. Now I'm snapping at this point. I'm like, well, why would you even suggest that? Just order the ones with fucking the silver, fuck it. Like, just order something that will work. Fuck is you talking about? Stop offering stupid shit. Fuck is wrong with you? Bitch. She's like, okay, we gotta take impressions again. So I'm mad, because I don't wanna do fucking impressions again, because I hate that fucking putty shit. It always makes me gag. So then this lady that I ain't never seen before, I'm sure she's a fucking nice lady. I've never seen her at this office this whole entire time that I've been going there. She comes over with a fucking mouth guard full of fucking putty. Like, literally the shit is like falling from the back. And I'm like, oh no, this ain't gonna fucking work. You got too much on there. She's like, oh no, it's fine. Just lean your head down. I'm like, lean my head down. It's falling from the back. It's too much on there. Tell me why she puts it in my mouth. I instantly gag. And she's like, okay, put your head down. Gagged again. And she's like, just put your head down, throw up on my fucking self. Put my head down, throw up all over my goddamn self. Bitch. Strike fucking three. Bitch, you made me throw up on myself. I told you it was too fucking much. Now I'm fucking walking to the street, the sink, with the putty still in my fucking mouth, with the tray and all, the lady still holding the shit. She's walking with me to the sink as I continue to throw up on myself and all on the floor and shit. And she finally pulls it out my mouth when we get to the sink, and she's like rinsing it off, and I'm looking at her while I'm cleaning myself up because I had to throw up all over myself, putty all over my goddamn face, putty all in a goddamn sink. And then she's rinsing it, and I'm seeing it, and I'm like, that shit look fucked up. I'm like, are you gonna have to do another one? And she's like, no, this one is fine. I'm like, bitch, do a fucking another one, because if this one don't work and my fucking retainers come back and it's fucked up, I swear to God, I'm spazzing. I swear to God, I'm going off on everybody in this motherfucking office. So she's like, no, this one is fine. I'm like, well, hey, whatever, whatever. So I'm cleaning myself up. Tell me why this lady walks back up to the sink to me fucking with another tray. Talk about, let's do it again and make sure. Bruh. I swear to God. Western Dental, y'all is a fucking joke. I swear to God, y'all is a fucking joke. Y'all overcharge on basic ass, routine ass cleanings, and y'all do fuck shit like this. So I'm sitting there, and she's like, yeah, we're gonna order you some more. We're gonna try to get it rushed ordered. Wait, let me back up. So I said, okay, so in the meantime, you got my braces off. I'm supposed to wear my fucking retainers fucking every day. So I'm like, you know, what's up? I'm like, okay, so if I gotta wear my retainers every day and you gotta order me a new retainer, what am I supposed to do in the meantime? She's like, oh, in the meantime, you're gonna wear these. These little two small ass motherfucking retainers that pop off all my mouth all the goddamn time. After I like click them back on and off fucking all the goddamn time. And, you know, it's probably just the fact that I gotta get comfortable with it, but they hella hard to talk with, and I can't close my mouth all the way because I feel like they didn't make them deep enough. So my teeth are like this when I wear them. It's almost like having a mouth guard on, like I'm playing football, fucking something. So let me show y'all what these bitches look like in my mouth. As you can see, they're too small. The wire is supposed to be towards like the middle of my teeth. And same thing with the upper. The upper, like, hung off healthy. And I have to do extra to make sure that they stay in. Like, I squeeze my mouth, my tongue at the top to make sure that they are all the way snapped in throughout the day. And, like, as you can see, I can't close my mouth all the way, cause both of these meet prematurely, so that's as far as my mouth goes. Now where are these? Ridiculous. I love the fact that they're gold. Unfortunately, they won't be gold for too fucking long because I have to get ones that actually fit. But in the meantime, I have to wear these little two small bitches. Meanwhile, while I'm sitting there and they're like, we're gonna try to expedite them. We're gonna schedule you an appointment in the next 2 weeks. But call before you come because we have to make sure that they're actually here. And I'm like, oh, you fucking call me when they get there. Oh, you were inconvenient. So she was like, you know, we're gonna try to rush it for 2 weeks, but it might come in 3. I'm like, go fucking figure, whatever. So then I'm like, okay, so what's up with my $50? Like, if I'm not gonna have gold retainers, you need to give me my $50 back. So then she say, oh yeah, we're gonna refund you that $50. So the girl from finance just so happened to walk by and she said, hey, we're gonna need to refund her $50 for her retainers because they don't fit. And then a lady gonna say, oh, like it was an issue. And then she was like, well, we had a problem with that yesterday. I'm like, so y'all just fucking up everybody's shit. And then you make it even more of an inconvenience by making it more difficult for me to get my money back because you don't know how to give me my money back for some shit that y'all got fucked up. And then she says, I'm gonna take your money, your phone number. I'll call you when we figure it out. You call me when you figure it out. You not about to give me my money back. It's 24 hours later. It's more than 24 hours later. I ain't got no phone call about my money. Why is it so complicated for you to figure out how you about to give me my $50 back? Meanwhile, if I don't pay my fucking bill the day that it's due, the next day you will fucking call me for it. And you will call me every fucking day that I ain't fucking pay for it. Like, bitch, you got a lot of... They got a lot of fucking nerve, man. Like, I don't want to fuck with y'all no more. Like, I don't want to go back. Like, I don't want to go back every 4 fucking weeks to see y'all to look at my retainers. I don't even fuck with y'all. Leave me in the comment box who has a struggle with their retainers, who hate their retainers, who decided to go a different route with their retainers, and if you do have a different type of retainer, did you request it? Was it recommended? Was it an option? Drop me some comments in the comment box below, as if y'all made it that far in this rant video. Other than that, that's pretty much all I got for y'all. To be honest, I'm still just talking about it right now, just refueled the fire. Like, I'm re-pissed the fuck off, and I want to call Western Dental and be like, what's up with my fucking $50? But I'm not going to be petty because it's $50, even though it's my fucking $50. And they be petty when they be looking for their fucking money. I'm not going to let this negative energy take over me. But they got until when I go and get my fucking retainers. If they don't got my money by the time I go back to get my retainers, then I got a problem, period. I don't give a fuck. On God. Other than that, I'm done. Thanks for watching my rant video. Deuces.